Mr. Speaker, this budget, these two budgets, the supplementary and the budget probable 2015, they meet all the criteria. If you were say, if there was a criteria for a budget to be failed, this budget, though both of them, they definitely pass because they meet all the criteria for failing this budget. We should not pass this budget. We should go back for redoing. Yeah, yeah. Mr. Speaker, if honorable members of parliament do not understand the technical details of the economic perspective of both budgets the opposition has given, then common sense and moral conscience will prevail in them. For instance, if the Prime Minister is putting 1.5 billion over into Prime Minister's office, it is wrong. If figures do not add up, then it is wrong. If the true level of public debt has been concealed cunningly in this budget and falsified details have been given, then it is wrong. Or the ECS is, if important budget documents have not been properly prepared for the budget session, when the budget is the most important strategy of any government, then the clear conscience must come into play immediately to say that there's something wrong. Mr. Speaker, you've heard of this thing called, as the saying goes, there's no smoke without fire. So suddenly there is a fire, and all this is happening. I call on all members of Parliament, Mr. Speaker, to take heed that if these budgets are passed, then there is no use of MPs becoming wise after the destruction has been made to the economy. And you recall back the 1990s when PNG had to go three times to the IMF for rescue packages. Let's not go down this road again. Recklessness, careless spending, out of the budget are dangerous things. Let's be wise and prevent economic destruction while we can, Mr. Speaker. This budget must not be accepted. This budget must be rejected. It is a hoax. It's a hocus pocus. It's a deception. Doesn't save PNG, saves a few in power and their friends. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.